Hey, what's up, guys? So next we're gonna do Sia the Greatest. Now, yes, my picture's small right now. I had to do that so we could see the web page we're looking at here. But I'll make it bigger once I start doing the video. So what we got here is we're talking about what the video is about. Okay, so that's what we're doing here. This is an incredibly sad story. I've watched a lot of people react to this. 90% of them has no clue what this is about, and I had no idea what it was about for a long time. And then finally I watched the reaction video, and they didn't go into great detail, but they basically said what was going on here. So I'm gonna do something similar to that. However, we're gonna talk about everything, the entire story. That's what we're gonna do. So here we go. So it says, writers from several media outlets, including E, Online, Cosmopolitan, Variety, People Magazine, concluded that the video is a tribute to the victims of the Orlando nightclub shooting. The video opens with a low drone and cuts between shots of an upset Maddie Ziegler. She's the dancer in a lot of Sia videos. She's dancing in here. She danced in the Chandelier video, the Thunderclouds video. She's done a lot of videos for Sia, and she is amazing. Okay, so, well, let's keep going. Okay, Maddie Ziegler painting rainbow colors on her cheeks. Okay, if you guys know anything about this, you should know what the rainbow tears are for. Okay, she frees 48 other young people trapped in a cage, 49 being the number of people killed in the shooting. Their freedom is short-lived, however. Later, a wall is seen filled with bullet holes as everyone falls to the ground and tears stream down Maddie Ziegler's face. Absent of any social context, it's all striking and beautiful and infallibly sad. With the knowledge that it was inspired by queer youth and friends gunned down in the act of coming together and enjoying themselves, and it becomes almost unbearably poignant. Sia keeps singing about having stamina. Kendrick Lamar's verse, omitted from the video, is all about surviving adversity and haters. What's so potent about the video, and so specifically awful about the massacre, is that its subjects do seem to have struggled and triumphed to find the freedom to flip out together. And they are still cut down. It's bookmarked by Ziegler crying. As is appropriate, there's no take-home moral to make what happened seem okay. Now, what they don't mention here is that there was one survivor, okay? She had played possum in order to keep from getting killed also. Now, that is extremely important I don't know why this article didn't say that, but yes, that's what happened. And that is what's shown in the video, okay? Now that we know a little bit more about the backstory, let's go ahead and do the video. Now, as you can see, there's the rainbow tears that we were just talking about. Now, the sound that we're hearing right now, I'm going to explain what that is later on. And this is something nobody else has caught. A lot of people was wondering why we're hearing the sound that we're hearing right now, and I'm going to explain that to you. Now, as you can hear, that sound is just going and going and going, right? It's important. That sound is very important. Now, I said something about this in the chandelier video. I got no idea what this gesture is, right? I would love to hear like an interview or something with Maddie Ziegler, and someone ask her what this like trademark gesture is, you know, like what does it mean? Like, where did it come from, you know? So, anyways, let's keep going. But she loves doing that. See, she's got all of them doing it too. Now, if y'all know, if maybe it's not something specific to Maddie Ziegler, but it's like a universal, like sign language or something like that, y'all let me know. Because I would love to know. Got stamina. Running, I close my eyes. Well, I got stamina. And I see another mountain to climb, but I. Now, look, in case y'all don't know, maybe this is the first see a video you're watching. Or maybe you've seen a few and you're thinking, like, Maddie Ziegler, she's okay, but she's not like this great, great dancer. Y'all are wrong, and I'm getting ready to show you. Look, she is a phenomenal dancer, okay? Let's go. I got stamina. Oh, I need another lover of mine, 'cause I got stamina. Don't give up, I won't give up, don't give up. No, Look at her go. Look at her go. Don't give up. Y'all see those moves though? Y'all see what I'm talking about? Hey, she is phenomenal. That's my word for her. Okay, phenomenal. And y'all, freaking Sia. Nobody else can sound like that. That's what I keep saying. She is a phenomenal singer. Let's go. Now look, this thing right here, what she's doing right now, I don't understand how she does all this. And she's, what else is crazy, y'all, is she's going through so many different types of dance moves that she's doing, and just really, really fast. You see what I'm saying? It's incredible, y'all. Now, y'all, look. Even though she's doing these awesome dance moves, she still takes the time to be silly. Now, look. I just love this video. I love this video, you guys. Now, some of you may be wondering why they're saying I have stamina. Okay, and I'm going to explain that to you. What she's saying is you have to keep your stamina, okay, because we're fighting against the hatred. Okay, that's what we're doing. We have to keep our stamina. We have to keep fighting. We have to keep spreading awareness that just because you're different doesn't make you bad. You should be free to be yourself, no matter what. I've said that many times. As long as you're not out hurting people, leave them, let them live their lives the way they want. They're not hurting anybody. Just you, so much anger and hatred for no reason. You got no reason to hate these people. It's really sad. It's really sad. We shouldn't be doing this to these people, Let them live their life how they want. You live your life, let them live their life. You don't have to hurt and take their lives away because you see it's what they're doing is wrong. You're wrong. Don't go out and hurting people like this. It's really sad that their lives were taken because of no reason. There was no reason for this. These people wouldn't have hurt anybody. Come on, let's go. See? Don't give up. See, when you give context, right? To the songs, then all of a sudden the lyrics in the song, it fits and it makes sense. You see that? It's really incredible, I think, what I'm doing, because I'm explaining like every part of the story, and then the lyrics fit in and helps explain. You see what I'm saying? So you fully understand what it's about, the everything. You understand everything. Nobody else is doing reactions like this. They're not. They'll do a reaction to just the video, and that's it. They're not gonna look at, usually, like 99.9% of the time, they're not gonna do any research. They're not gonna do it, which is fine. They could do it however they want. I'm not saying they're wrong for that. Let people be themselves. They don't want to do research. They don't have to. They can do their videos however they want, just like I can do mine however I want. And this is how I want to do it. I'm a researcher. I'm doing research. Yes, we're gonna enjoy the music. Yes, we're gonna enjoy the videos. Yes, I have to put it on a small window sometimes, because I know it would probably get blocked if I did it. Now, yes, it does take some of the quality away, but what I think ultimately, since this way I don't have to use any blur bars, I don't have to cut out a big chunk of the video because the video helps tell the story. And so for what I'm doing, which is the research, a lot of times the video is part of the story. The video helps tell the story of what's happening. See, like this, if we were just looking at a lyric video, yes, I could tell you about the rainbow tears, and yes, I could tell you about some of the dance moves she was doing, but without seeing it, we would be losing so much valuable content towards telling the story. Okay, so that's why we're doing it this way. So let's keep going. Now look, here's what I want to point out, okay? I know you guys can't see it too good, but hopefully, you're watching this on a computer or a nice TV, and you'll be able to see this better than I can see, because right now what I'm looking at, it's a pretty small window, okay? But if you want to, go back and watch the original video, and then you'll see it really good. Now, what I want to point out, as she was spinning around, she was making different faces when she was spinning around. I'm telling you, this girl, her talent is beyond anything I've ever seen in somebody that's primarily doing dancing, okay? This is unreal how talented this girl is. Let's keep going. And Sia is killing the vocals on this thing, just like she always does. She is an amazing singer. Now, I don't know what that dance move means either, and I've seen her do it quite a few times, and a bunch of other people do that when they're doing Sia videos, so I don't know too much about interpretive dance, so I'm still kind of new to this. Sia, watching her videos, that was the first time I ever actually saw interpretive dance, so I didn't know what I was looking at. I was like, what is this? I don't understand what she's singing about. I don't understand what these dance moves mean. It's different, but you know what? I love it. She's made me a fan. She loves talking about mental health. She loves talking about, having respect for people, even if you don't like what they do. You can still mind your own business. You don't like them, that's fine. Let them live their life. You live yours. It's not your job to go around judging people. Stop judging everybody. That's not your job. You live your life. Find something that makes you happy. They found something that makes them happy. Let them be happy. Come on, let's keep going. Oh, I got stamina. Not just for this, for anything that's wrong that I'm fighting against, I got stamina. Okay? Now, before she gets into this, because I don't want to pause it during this sequence. Now, what I said before, when she was spinning around, she kept making all those faces really quick. Her facial expressions are unreal, that she can express so much emotion and different emotions, and very quick and very fast. And you'll see that here. Hey, can you guys do this? Anybody watching this, could you make a video of you doing this and show me? I can't do it. It would probably take me 6 months to get it somewhere close to it. You know? Hey, this girl's talented. Hella talented. Let's go. Don't give up. I've got stamina. Such powerful words, you guys. And anything you want to accomplish, anything you want to do in life, keep your stamina. Don't give up. It is so important. You know, for you guys to really soak that in and use that, you know, when you're fighting opposition, when things are not going right, and you just want to give up. Listen to this song. I have stamina. I will not give up. Let's keep going. Oh man, this part right here, it takes my breath away sometimes, you guys. It really does, because I know what's coming. You know, I wish we could stop it here and say, okay, that's enough. We know we got the whole story now. That's all there is to it. You know, they're just gonna dance and have fun, and that's it. I wish we could do that. I wish that's what we could say. They all went home happy and lived their entire lives, and nothing very serious ever happened to them. I wish we could say that. But that's not how life works. You know, sometimes it's just shit. Sometimes it sucks. It really sucks. Let's keep going. We're here to tell the whole story. We're not just gonna stop it and say that's it. We don't want to do the rest of it. Nope. We're gonna do all of it. It's gonna be hard for me because I'm a good person. I care about everybody, you know? So let's keep going. Even though I don't want to. I don't want to keep going, but we got to. You know, that's what we're here to do. We're here to talk about the whole story, and we're not gonna shy away. You know, we're not gonna run away just because it gets us emotional. So let's keep going. Now, what y'all just saw in the background there, I don't remember, but I think they already talked about that. Okay. But we'll talk more about that in a minute. Now, what I want to say before we get to the, what's getting ready to happen, the rest of these dancers in here, I had mentioned it before, they are hella talented too. They are all killing this song and the video and see his vocals on this thing. Let's go. We're almost there. Just wanted to pause it for a second just to. We're almost there, guys. We're almost at the sad part. Just wanted to pause it for a second, kind of collect my thoughts, and sort of like get you have to be mentally prepared for a story this sad, Can't just rush into it. You have, cause it'll just break you. It's just so doggone sad. It'll just break your spirits and everything. But at the same time, if we are trying to spread awareness to say this kind of stuff isn't okay, then how are we going to do that without telling the stories, How are we going to do that without giving specific details about these types of events? And to say, look, this was wrong. Okay? It's not okay to do this. It's not. Not okay. Let's get into it. Even though I don't want to. But I love the song. I just hate that the song couldn't have been about something, that wasn't a tragedy like this. Let's go. So now we're looking at it here, okay? This is now, as you can see, they're all down. There's holes in the wall behind them. This is probably what the scene looked like when they came in. And I feel so bad for the people that had to come in and see this. I'm sure it ripped their hearts out. And the girl that survived, I couldn't imagine how much PTSD she would experience from something like this. And I hope and I pray that she's doing okay. She's definitely gonna would need a lot of help, psychological help, medication, just to cope, The This is terrible, you guys. It's terrible. We should all speak out against this. All of us collectively. Hey, even if you think what they're immoral, or if you think the religion aspect that God doesn't like that kind of stuff, even if you think that, that's fine. You could think that all day long, but at the same time, if you're gonna think that, you should also think it's also a sin to assault and attack those people. God still loves those people, okay? Don't you know that? We're all God's children. Regardless of how they live their lives, they're still God's children. If that's the aspect you want to look at this and say, well, what they're doing is it's a sin. Well, what's a bigger sin? Right? What's a worse abomination of God? To live their lives and not hurting anybody? Or someone who goes and attacks and assaults and kills those people who weren't hurting anybody. Even if you think those people are wrong and they shouldn't do that, you should still realize, okay, treat them as you want to be treated. Okay, it says that in the Bible. Treat as you want to treat people how you want to be treated. Just because someone is doing something that you personally disagree with and you think that they're wrong for doing it, doesn't matter. You're still supposed to have respect for them. Have respect for them. Treat them as an individual. We're all different. We were all created in our, we're all, we all have the right to express ourselves however we want. So let's keep going. This is, we're almost done. A sad scene we're looking at here. What a sad scene. Now I'm gonna explain the sound. Now a lot of people was wondering why that sound played at the beginning and now it's playing again. Why? What's that humming noise? Well, you have to realize what she would be hearing right now. Think about all the gunfire. That's a lot of gunfire in a small confined space. She probably still has hearing problems. Okay? That has probably ruptured her eardrums. I'm sure of it. Her eardrums are probably ruptured, and that's all she's hearing is mm-hmm, just that humming noise. Okay? That's why we're hearing that humming noise. That's probably what she would be experiencing. Her eardrums just vibrating and going crazy because of all those loud gunshots. I couldn't imagine it. I couldn't imagine. Let's keep going. There's one more point I'm gonna make, and then we're gonna stop this video. Oh man, this is it's hard to talk about, you guys. But it's important. It's important for a researcher to talk about this stuff. Okay, let's keep going. So I think what's happening here is I think she's like replaying it in her mind and seeing it happen over and over and over again. I've experienced that. When something bad happens, or when someone says something mean or nasty to me, or something like that, you have to remember, you're not just saying or doing that action one time. You could be doing that to that person for the rest of their lives, because their brain can replay it over and over and over and over. Sometimes it happens that way. So, if you don't want to mentally scar someone for the rest of their life, be kind to them, you know? Don't do that to people. Have some respect, have some dignity, have some compassion, have some something. Have something. Try to actually care about other people. Don't just care about your damn self. If you're going around and you're just constantly picking fights and yelling and screaming at people, you got to take a step back and you got to really think. That is horrible. That is a horrible life to live if you are constantly mad. Okay? That's not good. It's not good, you guys. If you guys get mad a lot, I want you to really try, right, to find some coping mechanisms. You gotta watch your temper, because you blowing up at people, you can really do some damage, I'm telling you. Let's keep going. So look, here's something else that I want to point out. How long she must have waited before she got up. Because you gotta think, you can't open your eyes and look. As soon as you open your eyes, if they're still there, then you're gonna know. Then they're gonna know that, that you're fine, you're still alive. So how long do you wait? How long do you wait before you know for sure that they're gone? Oh man, that feeling, that's the feeling I keep feeling when I think about that, is being scared and traumatized for however long she waited until she knew that they were gone, or at least until she had a good feeling that they were gone. Forcing yourself to open your eyes and look around. Oh, man, you guys. I couldn't imagine feeling that much pain and that much fear. And then to the families, that they lost all their loved ones. These are people's children. They had so much more to offer to the world. It's terrible, just terrible. Wow. What a performance. I mean, all the dancers and Sia singing such beautiful lyrics and giving hope when, a lot of people probably wouldn't have any. And she's trying to give them hope, and she's trying to point out things that's happened that's wrong. That's one of the reasons why I love Sia so much. She's not just doing regular music. A lot of her music is she's a freedom fighter. To me, that's what she represents. She's a freedom fighter, okay? She speaks out against injustices, and she speaks out against things that's happened that's wrong. She what a fantastic artist she is. You know what? I was kind of wondering. Aside from this, because of course with this she was talking about the LGBTQ communities. Of course she was talking about this in this song. But there's a lot of videos that features rainbows in it. Now, what I want to know, is she a part of that community, or is she just showing support for that community? You see what I'm saying? For me, I'm not a part of that community, okay? But I support them. So, any of the letters, okay, I don't represent any of those. But I support them. You don't have to be a part of them to speak out and say, hey, we should leave them alone. They're not hurting anybody. You don't have to be a part of them. You don't have to be in their community to show support. And that's what I'm doing. I'm showing support. So if any of you guys that are on the fence, you think maybe they're immoral, maybe they're whatever, I'm here to tell you, okay? It doesn't matter. You're not, it's not your job to judge them. It's your job to live your life. It's their job to live theirs. You're not getting judged for stuff that they do. Okay? And the vice versa. It does. You're responsible for your life. You live your life the best you can. Don't attack people because you don't agree with their lifestyle. All right, y'all. I'm going.